Alrighty. Tell me, I don't know what I'm doing, first lady.
It's all right, Shay, walked you through.
How do we unplug her mic?
Do you mean go into a little, finish up the ending so you jump in there?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, so what I was saying, the reason why we told, like, so the boy was really emotional, and I think sometimes people don't know when they're piling on, and he was emotional and crying, and so we were just, my thing is, let's have jokes and talk about anything other than whatever's going on to get him laughing, to get him back into his right mind, so he doesn't go home and hurt himself because he's so emotional about whatever. So we that's why Connor, we was like, if he starts up, if he looks, because he would look at her and start crying. If he starts up, Connor, you go fart in his face. That was the joke.
Okay.
That's why Connor was going to fart in his face, and we all started laughing. And I would look over, Connor, get one together. He's looking at her, so Connor would go over there and fart in his face. But that was the point, that sometimes people don't know that they could be that thing that sets someone over, over the top. And so you don't need to use this time to... And she was like, he's not going to hurt himself. I said, you don't know that. Don't know that.
That is very true. And I'm glad that you brought that up and used the term pylon, because I feel it's so... I'm so glad you brought that up. I feel the country does that to the black community. It's a huge pylon. And you mentioned something about just having, you know,
Baltimore riots are, right?
The pylon. That's pretty much what that is. It stemmed from that. When you mentioned the when somebody might say, oh, you know, I'll pray for you, that kind of a thing, right?
Right.
I feel the pylons for us, if you really look at our community, one pylon, especially for black males too, and black females as well, but especially for black males, the first pylon, they won't have much of a male figure in the house.
Right.
Boom, broken home. Three. Then it becomes, you know, the temptation of sports.
The smell.
Oh yeah, they usually do. It becomes the temptation of sports as opposed to education. That's the second pylon.
Right.
The third pylon, like there's so many pylons with the black community. There was one that I was thinking of when you were talking with.
Well, you know, with black men, it's funny because we never ask for help. From either even
it's
each
hard
other,
for us too, right?
It's extremely hard.
The other one is just not being sufficient enough to run, be head of household. I think that's the other
financially
that black men can't hold down a household.
And you know, for me,
are the breadwinners.
I will say that personally, like I am a very emotional person. Like I try, you might not see it, you know. But deep down, like, I really am. Like, there's a lot of things that I will think about. There are stories that I will hear about.
I have that problem, too.
If I tweeted or put on Facebook as many times as I cry, like, actually cry, people would be like, he's lying. He's completely lying. And it's not always, like, tears of sadness. It's tears of joy. Like, you hear somebody that's returned. Have you seen those videos of soldiers returning?
Oh, yes.
And then they surprise their children? I'm telling you.
Oh, yeah, that breaks me out in tears.
Waterworks all day long, you know. But how many of us
are... Who recognizes their loved one
don't
dying?
Care that much. Wait, what?
Like
the one that was crying at the gravesite.
Yes.
Yeah, I saw that.
And he just kept on
patting. I broke down. I got two dogs. The dog literally laid on the not the tombstone, but it was like a flat tombstone.
Uh-huh.
And I swear to God, if I'm lying, I'm dying. The dog was there sniffing like.
Yeah.
I broke down.
Yeah.
I'm looking for a new dog. Shout out if anyone has a Labradoodle poodle.
It's very
anything
touching.
That's hyperallergenic. But, you know, so it's one of those things that I empathize with people a lot. There are times that, you know, I'll hear a song, you know, that I just remember. And it's like it encourages me and I'll start crying because I'm like, yo, I think back to where I was and what could have happened and what probably even should have happened. Mm-hmm. And it didn't. And I'm like, I'm just so thankful.
Right.
So it's like I'm always in a spirit of thanksgiving. And it has made me this incredibly emotional person. And it's just like, wow.
But you know, with us, I think that the three of us are three of a small few where we are exceptions to certain situations.
Yes.
So for us, and because the three of us happen to be on that same page, it seems almost easy for us to talk about it and wonder, why isn't anybody getting
this?
But the reality, which is why I brought up before, that whole uphill battle and the pylons, it's the reality of that is a lot
Yeah,
it really is.
Well, it's the reason why a lot
for people to deal with.
You know, we have to be more open in our community and talk about it more. That, you know, we need to start getting out, like, counseling
and getting
help more, and we don't do that, and that's a problem. That's a big problem.
That's the problem, and that was the pilot I was going to mention. You see how you mentioned the, you know, I pray for you thing?
Right.
This country knows exactly what it's doing.
Yes.
Because when we try to find a solution, all of a sudden now that solution is no longer allowed.
Right.
Like how you can't talk about God in school anymore.
Right.
Like when we find a solution to get us over that hill, all of a sudden the country shuts it down. You can't talk about this. Don't bring it up. Blah, 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 blah. So then what's the solution? And then we find the next solution. That's against the law. It's now illegal in 50 states. It's like, well, what are we to do then? That's why I said the reality of it is so much.
And that's why I'm more so about just taking the power, you know. Like,
and then you go to jail.
And it's like, well, you know, I mean, doing it the correct way, you know, obviously,
by making
sure that when I say take the power, I'm meaning, you know, we take the political offices, we take over the major corporations.
That requires an education,
exactly,
which is what they're depriving us of in some way, shape, or form.
True,
it's like a domino effect.
It really is.
But
I think that
in some way, shape, or form, yes,
I do feel that.
How did we get ours?
I will say this.
I'll
say this. I think that it's, I don't know, because I just lost my train of thought.
How did we get our education?
I feel we're being deprived of education because, one, there's two reasons. One is somewhat our fault, in a way, because I think that we're tempted by money in other careers that don't need an education. The temptation is another, And you know, temptation can get you in a lot of trouble.
Well, that's why my mama didn't let me work only Saturday and Sunday, because she understood that, you know, as a little girl, if you don't understand what little money is,
what a lot of money is.
What a lot of money is.
Right, but so, I mean, that's why I said the temptation, because the temptation is usually, it's not really, it's the money, but it's also what is it that you enjoy doing. The temptation of sport, maybe you love playing football, maybe mm-hmm. you love playing basketball. It's a huge temptation. The second way I think to deprive us is the education that we're being given is not even accurate. It's not our history. That's a huge problem.
Go get it. They never teach me about my history. And I'm a history major.
But my thing is, for us black folks, there should be no reason that the starter level for us to learn our history as black people, the first level of us to acquire that should not be college.
But again, it's also our responsibility to teach that in our own homes.
Yep.
No, it is. But then we're sending off our kids to school
where
they are for 8 hours of the day learning what history.
Well, but I'll be honest with you. When I was in grade school, I knew about Augustus T. Tolton, who was the first archbishop in the Catholic religion,
mm-hmm.
the first African-American archbishop in the Catholic religion. And that was because I had to do a story, like a history thing, and my mother was not going to let me just write about Martin Luther King or Rosa Parks. She actually went out, again, single mother, got a book, and was just like, here are the unknown heroes, or can't remember the name of it, but I can still see that book today. If you were to put the book in front of me, I could identify it.
But that's my point. Your mom went and did that.
Right.
But now, did your mom teach you about George Washington, Thomas Jefferson, Abraham Lincoln?
I just don't put
our moms didn't teach us that. Who taught us that?
I just don't put that in there. Let me
tell
you something.
That is their responsibility, though. If you're a country that has
the Morris Compass.
You're a country that you house people of different nationalities and you pride yourself in that. That's what America prides themselves on, that they are the melting pot of the world.
Do they really pride it, or do they just
because they want everybody to come here?
Yeah.
But for what reason?
Regardless of the reason, you want everybody to come here.
It's what was founded on.
If you want everybody to come here, they're here now. How are you educating these people from different areas of the world? What are you teaching them? You're only teaching them American history? And even that history is not even accurate.
Well, I think they should teach American history.
But you gotta teach the rest of it.
All of it, though.
Yes.
I mean, I took European history in high school.
Crispus Attucks, the first person that died.
I learned about him in high school.
I learned about him. Yeah, but that's because I had to go.
No, I actually learned about him in school.
No, I learned about him in school, but to the depth.
Like grade school?
In high school is actually where I learned about him. The depth to which I learned about him was not from high school. I heard his name in high school, and there's a street near,
in
Rockford. There's a street. So that's pretty much the small dosage that they give you. They don't give you any more than that.
Right.
But they give you all this stuff about George Washington.
And but you know, and I think
Adams, don't do, though. I think let me tell you something that we don't do, right?
Ridiculous,
there was a
man.
There was a
but
guy.
We have a book. We have our own history book. I've seen it.
No, we do. Second. But that's my point. We don't get it till when?
That's Shay. I'm Dwayne.
I'm your
first lady.
Shawane.
Right.
Day.
Deshae. Listen, Deshae.
Always trying to shut the black man down. Deshae. Don't care what the name is.
I was listening to, I forgot which article I was reading. This gentleman, he's from Missouri. He might have been from Missouri.
St. Louis.
I said Missouri, okay?
That's where St. Louis
is. I know it is, but I didn't say the city.
She
okay?
said history. She didn't say anything about geology.
Okay.
Or...
Oh, but don't get it. She's a beast there, too, okay? So I'm reading this article, and this gentleman is talking about how he took his kids out of school for 4 days, and they came to Boston for the last marathon.
Mm-hmm.
And the school said that's not an excuse. That's an excuse absence. Like, we don't excuse family
what
trips.
What color
that's
is
an
this
excuse.
Man?
White. Family, he said, we don't excuse family trips. Family trips are not an excuse absence. So the man writes back, and he was like, what are you talking about? My kids have learned more in 4 days than you weren't going to teach them in a whole year. They went to the Freedom Trail. They went here. They went to... He just named up all these historical places that their
right.
kids went. Why we don't do that? When we go on family vacations with our children, where do we take them?
Well, I'm just going to say this.
We take them to Disneyland.
I'm just right. going to say this. Have you done the Freedom Trail?
No.
I've done it.
And that's right here. So it's like, you know, and I think it's one of those things
that
sometimes
that
we don't even...
We're not trying to home educate. It's not just done in school. Education is not just done in school. You know, the preparation that white people have, with it, they are reading to their children before they even start to go to school.
But
they
see,
are doing
I think
all that which we're not
I,
doing.
I think a few of
they
us are because I recently
to them in their bellies,
I recently
and playing music and
no,
all that.
Cuz I've had friends that have recently had children, and you know, I laugh at them because they have all these books and they're reading all this stuff and they're like, you know, they're posting stuff. I'm talking about one friend in particular, and
they're probably listening like
because you know, they used to put some really kind of interesting things on Facebook. Now they're talking about it's a right to vaccinate my children and blah blah blah. I'm like, really dude, you're
right.
talking about vaccination,
right,
Mr. Clinic Man?
Oh my god.
No, but just no, in all seriousness. So I think there again, I always say that we have to be responsible for telling our story, and I think that there are more
but
of us that are.
But take some responsibility of our children's education, though, too.
Yeah,
you
I think
know,
there are some of us that are.
As much as I know history, I know that there are things that I know I'm going to have to teach my child, and I can't put that responsibility just on teachers.
No,
I agree.
You can't put it solely on teachers, but I think that the responsibility that falls on them, they're not. Okay, put it like this: if you go to a doctor, and you get a checkup, right? The doctor does the you know, they do the regular checkup on you, you know, put the thing in your mouth, check your ears. Let's say that during the checkup, you just came in for a regular checkup, but let's say they found something that could
they
lead to cancer.
Do.
Right.
Like,
now,
like
this is your doctor. You only came in for a checkup, but they found something that could lead to cancer. Should they tell you?
Yeah.
Because why? It's their responsibility. So as a thank you. So as a teacher, your job is to teach me the facts, history. So yeah, we should teach our kids, but we're sending you to this building called school because we can't teach you everything. So it's, I feel, teacher's responsibility to make sure that if I'm sending my, you're getting paid, granted it's not enough money, but you're being paid to do a job. If your job is not getting done, you shouldn't be paid. Why do you have that job?
Well, I think it's, you know, I'll say it like this, and we have to be careful because it's like 10:47, so
right.
We do have to start with the wrap-ups. But I will say this. I have a few friends that are teachers. I respect what they do. I admire what they do. But I still have an issue with we put all this responsibility on a teacher if they're
exactly.
not doing their job. We want them. We want to get rid of them. But we have professional athletes.
And they actually have curriculums
we
that
have,
they have to follow.
We
they
have,
can't
right.
even just go off the cuff.
You can't
and
even
teach.
Get rid
right.
of them.
Right. And we have professional athletes that get, you know, a pinky injury But they still make their $3.5 million for that year. So yes. I think, again, going back to the America as a moral compass, we have a lot that we need to look at. So I will start the wrap up.
Wrap it up. Don't get any STDs, folks.
None. Clinic man. Not talking so about silly. Vaccinations.
Read a book, so now he up on some stuff.
Well, you better get that baby check. No, in all seriousness, thank you to every one of our callers that called in, especially St. Louis representing. I appreciate all the love and support. But I think that it's very important that we don't have to understand what's going on to condone it. Is that right? Am I saying that correctly? No,
it's the other way around. We don't have to condone it
to understand it. There we go. Right. So we don't have to condone it to understand it, but we do need to do something. So if you're not out there, if you're not a part of the solution, please believe you are a major part of the problem.
Yes.
And so we just have to do better. We have to take back our media. We have to be responsible for telling our stories. We have to be responsible for what's coming in and going out of our communities. And we just have to come together. Again, we have enough chiefs. Let's get some folks that are going to be on the ground, foot soldiers, for the cause. I respect Minister Farrakhan and what was shared of him today. It was mind-blowing, and definitely loved it. And you know, at the end of the day, I encourage everyone to continue to push their agenda forward as long as it's a positive agenda that's going to move someone else forward, and do it by any means necessary. Until next week, I will be in touch. Follow me on Facebook, Dwayne Trainer. If you're looking for a job, you know where to find me.
You want to go next year?
No, go ahead.
Oh, dang, I was trying to find something. Oh, okay.
So I just want to wrap up in saying that, you know, just to kind of close out on the topic of the show with the Baltimore incidents and things like that. I'll start off by saying that, no, I don't think it's right what was going on in Baltimore. However, if you asked me, would I have done the same thing? You best believe I would have. I hope that anyone who's listening, or you know, have listened, or even on Facebook making comments and just letting us know how they feel, I want people to understand really what's going on and why the whole Baltimore situation is going on. And I see folks who get mad and say, oh, you should have the peaceful protests and things like that. Peaceful protests get us nowhere. Peaceful protests get our leaders killed. Peaceful protests don't resolve anything. If someone can call in or even make a comment on Facebook and tell me what peaceful protest has occurred in the past that has got something done. And then I'll be able to really listen to their reasoning. But until then, that concept's out the window. So not that I'm saying this should happen in every major city across the country, but if it does, I wouldn't be mad. I really wouldn't. I would probably attend a couple, truth be told. Because something needs to be done. You can't keep doing wrong to somebody or a group of people and expect nothing to happen. I mean, the country, America as a whole, was victim to that, and that's how it was built. They were being victimized in England.
Yes.
So don't be the kettle calling the pot black. And black folks, please wake up. Stop listening to what you see on TV. The TV is designed to corrupt your mind. So like Dwayne and First Lady said, you have to go out and find out information on your own. You can't rely on the schools to teach it to you, because the schools are behind enemy lines. So what do you think they're going to teach you? So you have to go get this information on your own. Educate yourself. Empower yourself. We have a long climb. It's a really steep hill that we're climbing as a people, as a society. But like I said earlier, if we come together, help each other, and support each other, then we can get through it. It's not going to happen overnight. It's not going to happen next week. But in time, it'll happen. You know, you'll see progress, not on a daily basis, maybe more on a yearly, perennial basis, something like that. But it starts somewhere, and it really starts within our community and how we police ourselves and hold ourselves accountable. So that's my 1-2 for the day. Shout out to my fam. Big ups to my mom for cooking up some really good food today. Big ups to my daughter for her honor roll Big ups to my brother. And anybody listening, what was this week? Did anything happen over this weekend?
Yes, the walk.
Billboard
the
that
walk
got
for,
taken down.
Oh, the walk for hunger is.
Yeah. Was today.
It was today.
Yes. Shout out to all the people that participated in that. I've been wanting to participate in that for years, and I haven't even done one. I have a lot of respect for people.
We'll put it on the agenda for next year.
Yes, a friend of mine actually said that that's something
what?
That we should
to
be
walk
a part
for
of.
Hunger.
We should actually have our show part of
I'm
that
zoning.
Next year. I mean, dinner table,
what?
Walk for hunger.
You're not walking?
No.
Why?
I've heard people talk about how in pain they are. I just don't have it. Their feet and all.
It's a 20. How many miles is it? 20.
I'll say this. I've actually done the night out with the homeless before.
What do you mean?
Where you actually stay out.
And be hungry?
I wasn't hungry, no. I ate before I went. But no, I've done the whole night out. So we were out an entire night.
Mm-hmm.
Looking to see what it's like to be homeless. We should actually have a show around that.
That's
I'm very compassionate. I'm very compassionate for the homeless.
I'm very compassionate too. I'm just not trying to be out there. You better stop trying to make me seem like I'm not compassionate. I have empathy and all this other
first,
stuff that you.
First lady will be out
stuff.
There. She'll be in her bubble.
Exactly.
Like so. How does it feel to be homeless?
No, he did not. You're gonna try to play me like that. You're not gonna try to play me.
You know, okay. We keep it funky on the dinner table.
And
that's
jokes.
Right.
Don't be at home like, see? Nah, shut up.
She ain't even all there.
Yeah, she is. Listen, if you are watching TV and you somehow feel like you are disconnected, like Mariah said, like this doesn't affect you, that I live in Timberwood, so this is not a problem of mine. This is not in my everyday life. I just stay churched up. I just stay around church people. This could never happen to me. You're delusional.
For real.
And that's coming from First Lady. If you could watch this TV and think that you could have a child or you can be in this today's society and don't think that what's going on affects you, please wake up. This is a wake-up call. This is us telling you that this affects us all. First Lady is not from the hood. Went to great schools. Doesn't hang out in the hood. No, but this affects me. And this affects me because when I have a child, he's going to be black. And that's just what it is. And I'm going to worry about him. So, yeah, it affects me. It affects the fact that I have 6 nephews that I have to talk to them about. Don't talk to the police officer that way. I've had to calm down. I've had to sit there and make sure that they calm down because I understand if they go 2 octaves above, and to get to the point where that cop feels intimidated, this is a whole nother conversation. So please know that we're all affected by what's going on right now.
Sure.
And take a stand and have a conversation. You might have an opportunity to have a conversation like I did with a high school friend of mine or on Facebook that got her to understand. I love everybody. I love people.
But right now,
shut up. But right now, we could burn this thing down and start all over. And that's just where I am at it. Because you would not be plucking us off like birds.
There you go. So, you know, until next week, be sure to tune in every Sunday, 7:30 Eastern Standard Time here at StepUpRadio105.com. And don't just wait until Sunday. Tune in Monday through Sunday for the other various shows that we have. Big shout out to Stitchy, who typically comes in right before us. Big shout out to Foxwoods, Jinx, just, you know, all the other personalities that are out there.
Sean Hype himself.
And, of course, Sean Hype, the one and only not-so-hype Sean. No, I'm just joking.
And you can find me on Twitter at First Lady Speaks. That's First Lady and Speaks with a Z on the end of that. Also, the Dinner Table. Dinner Table 617 is also on Twitter. You know, and the gentlemen are also on Facebook. So.
Yeah, I'm on Facebook. I'm on Instagram, Dwayne_onair. I'm on Twitter, Dwayne.onair. But, you know, definitely connect with me on Facebook. Let's continue the dialogue. And whatever you do, do not take a window seat to what's going on.
Yes.
Because all hands need to be on deck. And until next time, we'll see you next week. So here's the thing, we're back.
Dwayne gets the kick.
I love this.
Oh my God, you guys have opened a release of the beast.
Yo, let me tell you something. About to take over. I'm already looking at, like, DJ equipment for my house, just everything.
What are you going to be doing at home?
I don't know.
There's no cowboy shindigs.
Let me tell you something. Rozzy is going to rock.
For all those out there that saw the picture posted on the dinner table wall of the R&B, female R&B group, and the question was, what is the name of this female R&B group? We didn't get any callers to call in about that. It was going to be a surprise. I was going to give away the Bath and Body Works to anyone who would correctly answer that. But the answer is Moke and Steph is the name of that group.
I remember them. I used to love them.
And their hit song was, "You may have had them once, but yeah, I got them all the time."
I remember that song.
That's the group.
Right.
Moke and Steph. So I'll post another one during the week.
I do have to say something I forgot.
Trivia.
I don't know if you guys realized this week there was a billboard hanging up in Grove Hall for like skin lightening. Something selling it like, oh, you're not happy in your skin by the skin lightener.
You see, that's wrong.
Shout out to
Did somebody take that down?
Shout out to Charles Yancey and Tito Jackson for getting that billboard removed and contacting Clear Channel. So yeah, that was like,
that's ridiculous. Why would they post
shout
that?
Out to them.
That's just stupid.
That's ridiculous.
It really
so
is.
Again, like we said, don't take a window seat.
Oh, and they talked about people calling in and calling them and emailing them and blowing up their phones about that.
Yeah, why don't
so
they post that
thing.
In their
that's
neighborhood?
That's what we should be doing.
Exactly.
We should be contacting our residents. Oh.
And they're contacting
us. We gonna block St. Louis, okay?
So here's the
Lou
thing.
Lou in the building.
I think that was
one more announcement. I just want to make a quick one. This Friday, for anyone interested, it's called Dance Hall vs. Reggaeton. I usually headline Friday nights, but because of how huge this is, I'm actually the guest DJ for the night.
Oh.
But I'm going to be
holding
it
down. Can I get a shout out if I come through?
Oh, for sure. Anybody who wants to come through, hit me up. Get on my guest list.
I'm getting on there.
You
coming
know, the
out this
table
Friday.
Staff is free,
don't
but for the rest of you,
man, he'll be home and his snuggie.
the rest of you come down and you can get on the.
I might have to work from home to get out there.
I think we're gonna start a dinner table guest list.
That's what's up
for nightlife.
You know what we need to because we got that June 28th. Can we start talking about that?
Yeah, of course we can.
June 28th, Sanchez is coming to Boston.
Yes,
I was actually at a fight party yesterday, told a guy about it. He was just like, yo, really?
He's huge.
I was like, yeah.
Who's Sanchez?
Yes, reggae artist. Old school reggae artist. He's huge. I actually named my dog after him.
Sanchez.
My dog's name is Sanchez.
Bloop, bloop, bloop.
Listen, I only know, like, really, like, name-wise when it comes to, like, reggae is, like, Patra and what's her name? The other female.
I don't know any of them.
You know Biggie Man, Bougie.
Yeah.
Shabba.
Yeah,
I know
you know
Shabba.
The old school
Shabba
name
Ranks?
Is what
that's
it is, probably.
What is Shabba?
And Shabba! Mr. Lover Lover.
Mr. American. Yeah. Queen of the Pie.
They call me Mr. Bombastic.
Telebontastic. Mr. Lover Lover said I'm Mr. Ooh.
No, I think
so you do that.
I do know that one.
I think that's Shaggy, actually.
I don't know.
Shabba sang the other one.
Until
Mr. Lover Man. Shabba.
Okay, and you know what? And on that note. And on that note, until
now.
Until next week, folks. Oh, big shout out to my friend Rakia. She tuned in for the first time tonight.
Nice.
She loves what we're doing. So shout out to Rakia. Enjoy this again. Do not take a window seat to life.
Peace.
need you to miss me. I need your attention. Yes, I need you next to me. Oh, I need someone to clap for me. I need your direction. Somebody say, you to need me. Anybody speak to Scotty, tell him be